Hey guys, welcome back to another video on Lounging with Legacy. For today's video, I have something I'm super excited. I'm so excited I can't even speak English. I have something I'm super excited to review. It is the one, the only. I will be reviewing Rare Beauty in this video today. If you know me, you know I love my wife. I truly love my wife, Selena Gomez. That's my heart. If you haven't realized yet, when you see me bare face, that means it's a makeup video. More than likely, that's probably what that's gonna mean. But yeah, so I'm gonna be reviewing Rare Beauty today. I did open the box because I had to make sure that everything that I ordered, that I was able to order from the day it launched, came with it. This came pretty quick. I ordered it when it first launched, which was September 3rd, and I got it like last week, maybe, I believe. I had missed it, and then they had to re-deliver it to me. So I got it like last week, I think. So yeah, it's still pretty new. Yeah, you know. Still pretty out there. But yes, I only got some of the products. So what I am going to do for this video, because I do want the whole collection, I guess. It's not a collection. The whole brand. I don't know the right word. The whole... Yeah, I guess collection. I don't know. Yeah, okay. I want the whole collection. So I did only buy... I did only buy certain items. But I will be buying the rest of the items, and I will be filming a video for my IGTV with the rest of the products that I bought, giving a review there. So make sure you stay tuned to the end of the video so you guys can follow me on IG and see that video when I get those products. I will be just adding on, not to whatever makeup I do here, but I will be using Rare Beauty, the products that I bought today, in my IGTV video. I'm just going to add on the new products, so it'll be like a full complete face. This is like half a face right now of Rare Beauty, but once I get all the products, it will be a full face of Rare Beauty. Yeah, I'm super excited to try this. Okay, so yes, it comes in this cute little baggie, which I think is super smart marketing. Like, I bought makeup and it came with a free cute little makeup bag. Like, what? That's cute. There's nothing on the back. It just says Rare Beauty. And all the products are in here. Yeah, so I'm just going to tell you guys. I'm going to show you guys and tell you what products I did buy. Too bad adulting, you know. I had bills to pay. I couldn't buy the whole collection. But I will, like I said, stay tuned to the end of the video. I will be posting the rest of the products on my IG. There we go. So what I got, first things first, I'm the realest. I got the, it's the Perfect Strokes eyeliner, matte liquid liner in black, because that's the only color she has. I'm super excited about this because I used to do eyeliner before in like high school, the beginning years of my high school, and then I stopped. So I love the way this looks. Like, it looks like it'll go on super easy. I'm gonna show you guys the package. This is the packaging. I'm gonna show you guys the product. I broke the box. Oh no, because of the sticker. But yes, if this works, I'm gonna be super excited. I'm gonna want her to release more than black, because this is like hella cute. It's super cute. It looks like a pen, like a little pen. It says Rare Beauty and like rose gold, gold. It's super cute. The tip looks like that. My nails, excuse my nails, guys. I need a fill-in. But they're not broken this time. But yeah, I need a fill-in. Yeah, that's what the tip looks like. So I'm super excited. When I get to the eyeliner part of this video, sounds like a marker. I hope the tip is like a marker. When I get to the eyeliner part of this video, I probably won't do it on camera because I haven't done eyeliner in so freaking long that I'm gonna need to look like in a mirror. What's next is, oh, they sent this freaking cute little primer. I didn't buy a big primer because I'm always using the same primer, but they sent a free little primer. Super small, but it's super cute. You can't really see the packaging like that. It's not really focusing, but yes, it's really cute. Next is the Liquid Touch Weightless Foundation. I got the shade 320W, which is 320 warm. It's a foundation elixir that feels barely there while building coverage and boosting your natural glow. So, I watched a couple reviews on Rare Beauty, and it was like two or three maybe. And the people that I seen were like complaining about the foundation, saying that it was like light, but it's literally in the name. So I'm not gonna, I love Selena. I won't be biased. But yeah, it's literally in the name. How can you complain? Say, I'm not a beauty guru. I don't know. Like I was watching beauty gurus, or supposed to be beauty gurus. So I don't really know, but I don't like my makeup feeling cakey. I know that for sure. And they were complaining like, oh, it's really light. If you like that, then, you know, it might be your thing. But I don't understand how you're complaining about something that's literally in the name of the product. Like, it literally says Liquid Touch Weightless Foundation. It's weightless. It's literally weightless. But yeah, I got 320 warm. Like I said, I'm super excited to use this. Okay, in the reviews, I did see them say that it was reverie, messy, and liquidy. So it did like spill out in the box. So that's a no-no. Their formulas must be very watery, which is kind of scary because now I feel like there's barely any product in here. Give me 1 second. I'm gonna go get some makeup wipes to clean this up, and I'll be right back. And I'm back. I'm gonna clean the bottle so you guys can see what it looks like without all the crap on it. This is what the bottle looks like. Much better, much better. It's a little dirty still, but yeah, it's super cute. I saw a lot of people saying that it kind of reminds them of Fenty Beauty, and I guess that's because it's like a clear bottle and a white cap, but I mean, who cares? Next thing we have is the Lip Soufflé Matte Lip Cream in the shade Thrilling. It's a whipped lip cream that delivers comfortable one-stroke color with a vivid velvety finish. It's matte. It's super smooth. Well, I guess this is matte. This is what it looks like. It's super smooth. Let me just clarify. I have seen the products already before. When the product first came out or something, or the day after it dropped, when the collection, I keep saying product, when the freaking brand dropped, I dragged my friend with me to Sephora like the literal next day so I could swatch all of the colors and make sure I got my shade and stuff, my concealer and foundation shade match correctly, because I got it the day it dropped and like I was just like beasting, so I really wanted to make sure it matched. So I have seen the products before, but I haven't fully put them on me. You feel me? So yes, I'm super excited to use that. Like, it's so cute, guys. It's so cute. I feel like that'll probably be my favorite thing, because I had a Kylie True Brown, when like that color first came out, and I was obsessed with it, and I ran out, and I couldn't find a color that I liked that matched, that felt the same way as that. So I'm really excited for that. And last but certainly not least for today, but like I said, stay tuned for the IGTV video on my Instagram, is the concealer. I got 280. I took it out the box already, sorry. 280N. This is what the box looks like. Who cares? Liquid Touch Brightening Concealer, a moisturizing, buildable concealer that melts seamlessly into skin for undetectable cake-free coverage. Because cake-free coverage is important, okay? And that's all, period. This is the concealer. It looks like a smaller version of the foundation bottle. Super cute. Super cute, super cute. So I got a lighter. When you match yourself on their website or even on Sephora for the concealer and foundation, they were trying to match my concealer to a shade that was like the same color as my foundation. But I got a lighter one. I chose to go lighter because I like my concealer to be lighter, you know, brighter, because it makes your face brighter. So I don't know if you guys know or not, but yeah, I like to use a lighter concealer because it makes it brighter. Bam, there we go. Yeah, because I used to have really bad dark circles, but they're not that bad anymore, I guess, because, you know, quarantine, I had nothing better to do. Yeah, so that's it for all the products that I bought. I'm going to start with the primer. I'll put it in the box and now I can't get it out of the box. So I usually when I put primer on, I usually spray a primer spray first, which is from this brand. This is A2O, which is a Shop Miss A brand. All right, that's a super good store. This is not promo, but if they want to promo me, holla at me, Shop Miss A. But yeah, this is a super good primer spray. I use all of their products, like all of their products, majority, but you know, I might have to switch it up between Rare Beauty and Shop Miss A. Yeah, I'm gonna spray this on my face first, and then I'm gonna put the Rare Beauty primer on. It smells so good, like fruity or something. I love it. Okay, so this is the, what is this called again? The Always an Optimist Illuminating Primer. A weightless universal gel primer enriched with ultra fine pearls for a light from a lit from within glow. Just gonna pump. Oh, okay. So I don't know if you guys can see that. The primer that I usually use from Shop Miss A is usually clear. So the Rare Beauty one is not clear. It has like a, not a tint to it, but it's like a pearly color, as you guys. That was stupid. But yeah, it's like a pearly color. So I hope this looks good. They fell in love one summer. A little too wild for each other. Shiny till it wasn't. Feels good till it doesn't. It was the first real lover. It actually feels really moisturizing a little bit. Kind of, it's not too crazy tacky, but it's actually not really tacky at all. Maybe a little bit, which is not too bad. I guess it'll keep the makeup on there. But I like it. It adds a little glow. You see that? Look like I got a highlight on. Wait a minute. Primer. Heard you, Miss Selena Marie. All right. So next in my makeup Why can't I speak English today? Next in my makeup routine, I usually do my eyebrows. Selena does have an eyebrow pencil, but I had to pick and choose the items that I really wanted the most first. And that was not one of them because I have a really good eyebrow pencil right now. That's also from Shop Miss A. I used it in my very first video. But I will be concealing my eyebrows. I'm going to do my eyebrows probably off camera. But I will be concealing my eyebrows with the Rare Beauty concealer. So we're gonna see how that goes. Let me see if I can do my eyebrows on camera. Also, Selena does have a sponge and she does have a foundation makeup brush. I'm not a makeup adding, I'm not a putting foundation on with a makeup brush kind of girl. I think my beauty blender works just fine. I did not buy her beauty blender or her makeup brush. I don't think I will, because it's not any, like, it's products, but it's not important products, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna use my good old regular beauty blender that I also got from Shop Miss A. I feel like I'm promoting them. I promise you, I don't have any deals. But maybe soon, maybe in the future. You never know. So yes, I'm gonna just do my brows. Of course she was sad, but now she's glad she dodged a bullet. Took a few years to soak up the tears, but look at her now. Watch her go. Look at her now. Watch her go. Look at her now. Look at her now. Watch her go. Look at her now. Last night I caught him. That new life was his problem. Not saying she was perfect. Still regrets that moment. Like that night, was it wrong, was it right? Yeah, what a thing to be human. Made her more of a woman. Of course she was sad, but now she's glad she dodged a bullet. Took a few years to soak up the tears, but look at her now. Watch her go. Time to conceal the brows. This is what the I'm gonna show you guys what the applicator looks like. Let me just rub off some of them. Okay, this is what the applicator, let me put this down. This is what the applicator looks like. If you can, I don't know if you guys can see it. It's like slanted. It's not like regular. There you go. I don't know how to explain it. It's like that, but like square-ish, not like a regular applicator. It's cute. Well, anyway, back to this. Now I'm just going to conceal all over my face, pretty much.
I want a boyfriend, but I just keep hitting dead ends. Try to take a shortcut, but I get cut again and again. I want a boyfriend, tell me all the any good ones left. I keep finding wrong ones, but I want love again and again. I want a boyfriend, I've been up and
like a tribal member or something. I'm crazy. I'm just gonna blend this out now, you know. Hopefully this is easy to blend. I guess we're gonna see. I mean, we kind of saw with the eyebrows, but I also put too much, so it blended. It looks like it blended pretty good though.
Pretty restlessly, think I might know why. I've been doing just fine, but baby, that don't mean that I'm feeling into you and me. There's a difference between all.
Okay, well, it definitely blends out pretty good. It also doesn't dry pretty quickly. Some concealers, they dry really, really fast. So you have to blend them really, really quickly. I look a little crazy. Looking a little ghosty. If you guys seen that episode of Sweet Life with Zach and Cody, comment down below. Yeah, okay, the concealer's not too bad. My skin recently has been very oily dry. I don't know if it's because of this lotion that I was using that had like bug repellent in it or whatever, but it's been very oily dry. So hopefully, I'm not gonna lie, the concealer feels like it's drying on my face a little bit after the primer made it feel moisturized. Maybe that's just me because my skin has been tweaking lately. But hopefully that goes away with the foundation, which is next. After foundation, I'm gonna do contour. I'll probably do contour off camera because I don't believe Selena came out with a contouring product or like a contour pencil or anything like that. You could use a darker foundation, or I'd probably recommend a darker concealer. I'm not a beauty guru. Disclaimer, just want to keep reminding you guys that, but I'm not a beauty guru, but I would recommend using a darker, probably concealer better than a darker foundation as contour. I'm just going to use this contour pencil that I have that I'm like obsessed with, that's also by Shop Miss A. I really should be sponsored by them at this point, but yeah. So I showed you guys the bottle earlier and it was leaking, it was a little messy. The tip of this is like a regular little brush. It is very liquidy. So that's true to the name. It's very liquidy. It's a liquid foundation for sure. I don't know if that's because it's supposed to be lightweight. I'm probably overusing. But I probably really am overusing because it's supposed to be full coverage. So.
Yeah. I want a boyfriend, but I just keep hitting dead ends. Try to take a shortcut, but I get cut again and again.
So now we're gonna blend this out. Yeah. Keep in mind, I said I'm going to do contour afterwards, so I'll probably come back with my face fully blended and contoured. Watch it. I kind of like that I have like a little glow. You guys see that? Like, that's the foundation. I haven't put no highlight on. Nothing. That's just foundation, concealer, and the primer, and it looks really good. What the heck? It's super blended. It did oxidize a little bit. As you guys can see, I'm more of one color now. Yeah, I kind of love it. Like, look at that, guys. I know you guys see that. I'm kind of living a little bit. Miss Marie Gomez. Okay, honey. I'm going to show you guys what the liner looks like again. And I'm going to do it off camera, like I said. But I am definitely going to tell you guys how I like it. If it was easy to use. So on and so forth. So give me like 2 minutes at attempting to do this. And I will be right back. All right, I'm back. So I did a pretty decent job. Like I said, I haven't done this. I haven't done this for the first time in a very long time. I did it without tape. But this was super easy to use. It is exactly like a marker tip. So that's super cool. I'm definitely going to use this again. The more I use it, the better I'll get. I know that for sure. So I'm excited. I'm excited to continue using this and like figure it out. And it was everything was super cheap, guys. I forgot to mention that in the beginning of the video, but everything was super cheap. I think this was like $19 or $12 or $16, something like that. But I'll definitely put everything, Rare Beauty, like the prices of the stuff that I got in the, not in the link, in the description for sure. But yeah, I totally like this. Low key, I think my favorite thing so far was still the primer. But the last but not least, oh shoot, last but not least is the lip souffle. I'm super excited. I know I said this already, but I'm super, super excited for the lip souffle. Actually, I'm gonna highlight and set my face, and then I'm gonna put the lip souffle on. Selena does have a highlight, like illuminizer highlighting like liquid highlighter, but I didn't get it, so I know I keep repeating this, but stay tuned for my IGTV video because that will definitely have that in it. That was one of the main things I wanted to get, but bills played me. So yes, yeah, stay tuned for that. I'm gonna use regular highlighter and stuff now, so I'll just come back highlighted. And Selena does have a setting spray as well. That's not gonna be in the IGTV because I watched reviews, and based on the reviews that I watched, the highlighter, the setting spray leaves you really dewy and like glowing. Like I said, my skin's been acting weird. It's like oily dry, so I don't want to spray it and then I look way too oily. So I'm going to use this makeup setting spray and I'm going to put the lip souffle on. Oh shoot. Lip souffle on now. Like I said, I'm super excited about this. I have a little bit of Blistex on. Not too much. Wow. Okay. So the brush, the applicator is like slanted, if you guys can see that. It's not like a regular applicator. I guess that's because she doesn't have liners. I watched her interview saying that's why they did it, so that, you know, it'll fill out your lips, like it'll line your lips in a way with that applicator tip. Super cute, super cool. Smells good. Yeah, I want a boyfriend. Tell me all the ending goodbyes left. But I want love again and again. I want a boyfriend. I want a boyfriend. I could phone a friend, use a hotline or something, but they won't get the job done. One thing I hate about lipstick and like matte lipstick is that it gets dry and it gets like not cakey but like cracked. It makes it cracked and it gets dry and it feels nasty, like absolutely nasty. I hate wearing lipstick. I was obsessed with the True Brown, but it did the same thing. This is so smooth, like so smooth, guys. It's so smooth, guys. I'm mind blown. Like, this is crazy. This is crazy. I realized I never took out my AirPod. But yeah, this is my Rare Beauty look of what I have. It looks really freaking good. Yeah, I love it. I'm super excited. I can't wait to get the other products that I really, really want. Me not knowing how to do wing is what's kind of messing up the look, but I love it regardless. Let me go back. Yeah, I love it regardless. It came out really good. Of all the things that I reviewed, the the lip souffle has to be my favorite. The lip souffle, and I do like the liner, the little eyeliner pencil. I just don't know how to use it. Like, I know how to use it, but I haven't done it in so long, so it's just like, it looks crazy. But the foundation is really good. It doesn't look like I have a lot of makeup on. Usually you can't see this little beauty mark on my face when I have like other foundation on. It looks really good. I love it. Lip Soufflé is my favorite. I highly recommend. Like, I'm gonna get like all the other colors that I wanted to get. I'm excited to use the chapstick because this was great. Like, I love this. Definitely my favorite. I really like the primer. Like, I'm actually probably gonna buy a bigger one because I love that. Like, I have the highlight here now, so you know, you can't really see it, but y'all saw before I put the highlight on and there was already a natural glow, so I really really like that. I'm probably gonna get a bigger primer. I'm definitely gonna buy more Lip Soufflé. I love the foundation, I love the concealer, they were all really good. The only thing I didn't like about the foundation was that it did run, like it was runny and liquidy, but it was really good. I guess it's full coverage to the extent that it's supposed to make you look like you don't have any makeup on. I don't really like my eye look, so that's probably what's really throwing me off. But this is what the products that I have of Rare Beauty. Thank you guys so much for watching another Lounging with Legacy video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. I still have this in my hand. Clearly my favorite thing. You know the vibes. Stay tuned for my next video. I am super excited about it. I may or may not have a little special guest in my next video or whatever. But yeah, but make sure you guys follow me on IG at Aspiring Legacy. It's gonna be right here. At Aspiring Legacy on IG, so you guys can see the IGTV video of me reviewing the rest of the Rare Beauty products. So I was gonna say collection again. Rare Beauty products, and it will truly be a full face of Rare Beauty. But yeah, like I said, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and stay tuned for my next video. Bye!